Hi, Charlotte. Can I see the screen?
Yes.
Okay. What do you mean by congruence and similarity? In general terms, what do you feel?
Congruence is the different types of shape and similarity is the same shapes.
Okay, that's true. That means the congruence and similarity are related terms, but they are having some different properties. Like congruence essentially means that two figures or objects are of same shape and size. So condition is the shape must be same and size must be same. This is congruence, okay?
Yes.
But its orientation, location can be different. Got this point? Congruence objects are identical. Their orientation with respect to one another and their physical condition coordination in a plane or three-dimensional space will often differ. We can see here this two triangle, right? This triangle, every angle is 60 degrees. So since all the angles 60 degrees, opposite of the angle, the side will be similar, right? As we understand before,
yes,
that if we have this, the more the angle, the opposite side will be the longest, right? If it is 90 degree, then the opposite side will be the longest one. Since all the angle are same, so the opposite side also will be the same, okay? This is called what? Equilateral triangle. Okay, in Bengali it's called Samobahu. Shobgule bahu saman. Okay. So these two angles having the same shape, it looks like both are angle. And they are having same size because all are 60 degree means that all the sides will be the same. So this is actually congruence. Okay. Look this picture. One is bigger, one is smaller, but these two shapes are same, right?
Yes.
So similarity means that two figures or objects are of same shape, although usually not of the same size. In congruence, same shape, same size must be there. But in similarity, if it is same shape, then we'll say this is similar. Two circles will always be similar. Here what we can see, because by definition they have the same shape, both are circle, right? If the circle have radius of different length, however they will not be congruent. So these two circles are similar shape, so it's a similarity is there, okay, but they are not congruent. If we have the similar shape and similar size, then it will be congruence. Okay? Clear?
Okay. Yes.
So yesterday we have learned about what? We have learned about Pythagorean theorem.
Pythagoras theorem.
So here also like this, we have added one angle. Okay? So this triangle is similar to the biggest triangle, right? That we have learned earlier.
Yes.
Because their shape is same, but the length is different. A size is different. Size doesn't matter. Matter is whether shape are same or not. Okay. That's why we have taken this also as similar with the biggest one, the whole one. Is that clear? Congruence and similarity?
Yes.
So the letter congruent comes from Latin word, congruo, which essentially means I agree. Okay.
Yeah. That means
in geometry, if two objects are described as being congruent, the implication is that one can be mapped exactly to others. That means if I put this object on top of this object, it will be matched with every side. Okay, we may need to change the orientation, but orientation doesn't matter for the congruence. Congruence for same shape and same size. And similarity, if the shape is same, then we'll say these are similar. Got this point? So what we understood?
Yes.
Two objects.
Congruence are the exact same shapes and sizes, while similarities can be the same shape but different sizes.
Exactly.
I did.
Okay. Now see, which one's congruence, which one similar? Tell me. Let me point the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Tell me.
Okay.
Are they similar?
1, 2, and 3 are congruent.
1, 2.
So they are all similar.
They are all similar. 1, 2, 3 congruent. How?
1, 2, and 4.
Four. Yes. These three are congruent, but all are similar, right?
Similar. Yes.
Okay. So by definition, we can say two objects are similar if they have the same shape. So that one is an enlargement of other. The two objects are congruent if they are same shape and size. Okay. Now let's understand scale model and factor. So in enlargement or reduction, okay, the corresponding angles are equal. Two corresponding length are in the same ratio. They have the scale factor. Like, let's take some example. This is one, this is another, okay? So what we are doing, this is the enlarge of this one, right? See, 2 centimeter, it become 4 centimeter. Yes. That means factor of 2. Then 1.5 centimeter is 3 centimeter. So this one, we can say this is enlarge of this one. So the corresponding angles are equal. The angles will be the same. See, these angles will be the same. Corresponding length are in the same ratio. This will be in the same ratio, right? Like 1.5, if we divide this by for the 3, then we'll get a ratio, okay? They have the same scale factor. Like this, if we multiply these two, if we multiply this with 2, it is 3, right? If we multiply with this 2, it is 4. So the multiplication factor is same. So it will be enlarged. They have the same scale factor. This is called scale factor. Got this point?
Yes.
So the scale factor is greater than 1 for an enlargement. It must be greater than 1, right? Otherwise, it will be the similar, same object or congruent object. It must be more than 1, the scale factor. The scale factor is smaller than 1 for reduction. If we made the scale factor less than 1, then it will be reduction. That means if scale factor is 1, it is same shape it will show, same thing. If we multiply by 1, it will be 1.5 centimeter, multiply 1. 2 centimeter. If you multiply by 2 more than 1, that means it's enlarging, right? If we multiply by 0.5, it will be reducing. This will be 1 centimeter, this will be 0.75 centimeter, right? It will be smaller than this. Got this point?
Yes.
So triangle A is enlargement. Triangle A, this is, if we say A is enlargement of C, okay? With the scale factor of the triangle C is reduction of A. If we think differently, this is the first one, then we are reducing this one. Reduction of A with the scale factor of 0.5, right?
Yes.
So this is enlargement and reduction. So calculation with similar object, similar shape. How will calculate the similar shape? Let's take two shapes are said to be similar if one is scaled version of another. Means their corresponding angles are equal, their corresponding sides are in the same ratio. It must be in the same ratio. So let's take an example. Okay. So here what? See here. Check that their corresponding angles are equal. The corresponding angle, this angle equal, right? 90 degree. This angle,
yes.
This angle equal. This angle, this angle equal. This angle, this angle equal. So corresponding angles are equal. All right angles, so equal. Check the ratio of their corresponding side. So let's take the side of A, or we can say with this A and B, okay? This is one side, this is one side, okay? If we take this one, 30 millimeter divided by 20 millimeter. 20 millimeter. That what will be? It will be 1.5 millimeter. This is ratio. We write the ratio this way, right? Or we can do one thing also. 20 millimeter divided by 30 millimeter equals to 2 by 3 millimeter. This is the ratio. Okay.
Okay.
So it will be the same ratio. Dominoes are similar, missing side. Start with the shape containing the missing side. Okay, let's do some practice. How will go? So start with the shape containing missing side. So what we'll do? So we can have this x equals to scale factor. This is formula into corresponding side, right? So let's calculate something. See, this is two shape. These are similar but not congruent, right? So we'll need to find the value of x. How we'll find the value of x? First, we'll need to find the scale factor. So what is scale factor here? See, corresponding side, this and this, right? This also top, this also top. So we'll make the ratio equals to 5 by 20.
5 divided by 20.
20 ratio, 1.4, 1 by 4. So if we put this formula, x equals to scale factor, we have 1 by 4 into corresponding side. Corresponding side is what?
12.
This is and this is, okay? 12. So this will go cancel. So this will be 3, okay? That means x equals to 3. Very easily you can find, right? Right? So x equals to scale factor is to corresponding side. So how we can find the similar triangle? For triangle, for any triangle, if pairs of corresponding angles are equals, then ratio of the length of corresponding sides are equal and triangles are similar. Okay. Let's take. Oh. So this is triangle, one triangle, the another triangle. Okay. So what we'll have to do, we'll have to check whether corresponding angles are equal. If this is equal, this is equal, this is equal, this is here, this is theta, this is theta, this is y, this is y, this is alpha, and this is common for both, right? So their side angle will be the ratio. Okay. So we'll need to find the ratio of length of corresponding sides are equal and the triangles are similar. If ratio are same, then it will be similar. Or conversely, you can say if ratio of length of corresponding sides are equal, then pair of corresponding angles are equal, then triangles are similar. Okay. If sides are there, so we can say if ratio are similar, then we can say that the angles also equal. If we see this, the angles are equal, then corresponding side also equal. So here, let's check, given AD is how much? A and D is 15 centimeter, right? Okay. AB, this point, okay, and this point is 12 centimeter. Okay.
Okay.
And DE, this one is 10 centimeter. Okay. Find the length of DC. So we'll need to find the length of this one. How we'll find the length of this one? See, BC is parallel to D. This is parallel. Okay. So the corresponding angles are equal. Since what we have learned earlier, so if two line are parallel, if something taken like this, so the corresponding angle will be equal, right? This one will be equal. We have learned earlier, right? So that means this angle equal this angle equal this angle. Okay. This means that the angle triangle ABC and ADE are similar. Of course, these are similar. Okay. Split the triangle into their component. So if we split the triangle, how will you get this two triangle here, right? This is one triangle. So this will be another triangle. Okay. If we split this triangle, it will look like this. Okay. So now what we know, we'll need to find the scale factor. So what is the scale factor here? Say here, scale factor equals to corresponding side, ratio of corresponding side. That means AB, we'll write AB, this side and this side ratio, AB and AD, okay? Equals to what? This is 12, this is 15, okay? Equals to, if we cancel with the 3, this is 5, this is 4, that means 4 by 5, okay? And corresponding side DE is given what? 10 centimeter, okay? That means DE equals to 10 centimeter. So X, what will be the X? X equals to scale factor into corresponding side length. Okay. Scale factor is what? 4 by 5.
Into 4 by 5 divided times 10.
10 centimeter. So we can cancel this one with the 2. That means 8 centimeter. Okay. This is how X equals 8 centimeter. This is how we can find the corresponding side. Okay.
Oh.
This is for angle.
Okay.
So what about for scaled area? How the area will be calculated? Suppose given something like this, enlargement from A to B, scale factor is 2. So what will be the area? How will find the area? Area is given 6 centimeter square and this area is given 24 centimeter square. Just wait. Got this point? So here, what is giving? Area A equals to 6 centimeter square. Okay. The scale factor given what? Scale factor is 2 is equal to 2. So scale factor square, since we are talking about the area, so it must square. Okay. Square equals to 2 square equals to 4. Okay. For area B, area B is given equals to 24 centimeter square. That means area B equals to 24, we can write like 4 into 6 is equal to 4 into area A, right? 6, okay?
Yes.
We can find, because how? We know the scale factor is here, scale factor square 4. So 4 into 6. So the area of B is what? We'll need to find the area of B. Okay. So area of B equals to scale factor square. Factor square into original area. What will be the original area? Is equal to this is the formula we have found from area B. Got this one? 4 is what? Scale factor square. And the area area of A. Original area. Okay.
Area.
This is the formula.
So 24 times 24.
No, not 24. Scale factor square is what? This is 4. Okay.
Yes.
If we divide 24 by scale factor, we'll get this. The area of A. Okay.
So it's a 6.
Yes. Very easily we can find like this. So let's take some example. This is A. This is B. Okay.
Yeah.
So here, can you find this area of B from this shape?
Area of B is the scale factor.
Area of B will be what? Scale factor.
Scale factor times original area.
Factor square. Since all the area is square, so original area. Okay. So what is the scale factor square? Scale factor is given like this. The scale factor 2. Okay. The scale factor also.
Okay.
So given shape A enlarged by scale factor of 2. Okay. So it will be what? 2 square into 16. Okay, this is 16 centimeter square equals to 4 into 16 equals to 64 centimeter square. This is the result. Very easily you can find the shape, right? Is that clear?
Yes.
Okay. Similarly, okay, for if it is volume of cubic object, it will be volume. Formula will be volume of B will be scale factor to the power cube, okay, into original volume. Okay, volume, do you know meaning of volume? So if you want to find like this,
volume is
this is. If you want to find the volume of others, when you know the volume of one, then you can use this formula, scale factor cube into original volume. Clear?
Yes.
Okay. Now let's try. Your question. Okay. What it's saying? It's saying, given that triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR, find the value of the unknown in each of the following pairs of triangle. Can you do that?
Yes.
How will you do that?
The answer is the scale factor times original area.
Factor time original area. Okay. But it asking for what? Unknown. It's asking to find the unknown.
Three of the unknown.
Yes.
X, Y, and Z. I have to find those.
Yes. Scale factor, first you will need to find the scale factor, right? So these two are what? Similar. Okay.
Yes.
This is B and Q are similar. Okay. What is the unknown? So this one, this one similar. No other value given.
Scale factor. 2.57 is the scale factor.
How you are finding the scale factor 2.57?
By dividing 90 with 35. Dividing 90 with 35.
This is 35. Where is the 90?
Yes. It's a right angle, so the 90 degrees there.
Okay. So what will be the scale factor?
2.57.
Then what will be the original size, the other side size?
The other side size is the original area. How do you find an original area? I forgot. How do you get so the original
there is
area?
No original area. It must be. It must be side. Okay. So what we learned before, if pairs of corresponding angles are equal, then ratio of length of corresponding sides are equal. And the triangles are similar. Conversely, if ratio of length of corresponding sides are equal, then the pair of corresponding angles are equal, the triangles are similar. So here there is no length. So we have what?
The 90 degree.
Now you will need to identify this unknown value. This is y, z, x. This you will need to find. So this is the
current. Y is 35 degree.
Y is
35 degree.
How?
Because the other one is 35 degree, and since they are both the same, the angle should be same as well.
Think again, they are not congruent, they are similar.
Similar.
How to find them? See this one.
180 degree.
Huh?
So you use the
90 degree divided by 35 degree. Okay. What will be the ratio?
2.57.
Okay. 2.57 reduced, right?
Yes.
So if it is reduced by 2.57, since it's a 90 degree, this must be 45 degree, right? These two are 45 degree. All
yes.
Right. 45 degree or 45 degree. So this will be enlarged by 2.57.
So 35 times 2.57.
45 times 2.57.
Oh.
So once you find this one, okay, once you find this one, add these two and you can deduct from this one. The total size of triangle is what? 90 degree, right?
Yes.
No, sorry, 180 degree. So deduct from the 180 degree.
180 degree, no way. Oh, yes, 180 degree.
180 degree. Next is what? B.
The 28 is 180 degree.
Think and tell me.
The 118 divided by 90 degree.
Mm-hmm.
118 divided by 90 degree, then the answer will be multiplied by 28 degree.
What is the 90 degree? The first one is not 90 degree.
Yes. No, wait.
Mm-hmm.
It's not. 118, I have to then divide 118 with 28 degree and then the scale factor with 28 degree.
Scale factor with 28?
Multiply scale factor with 28 degree.
Okay. Think again. So see here, the simple way you can do this angle, ratio of this angle and this angle, okay? We can write
okay.
This angle one, you can write angle ABC divided by this one, 118, okay? Equals to the ratio must be same, right? This angle,
yes,
and this angle, that means 28. Divided by x0, okay? And this angle must be same. So how you will find this?
ABC time.
Just 1 second.
Hello, it's a mute one. Hi. Hello, we mute. You should not say now.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
See, since these two angle and this angle are different than this, okay? So these two are not similar,
okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Because they must be, their angle must be same to be similar, okay?
Okay.
So you just cross this one. Number B, here what it's saying, see, here 118, this is unknown. That means this also will be 118, right? Since these are similar,
yes,
angle will be similar, 118, this will be, okay? So we'll need to find the y. So what will be a y degree? That means total is 180 degree, right?
Yes.
If we deduct 118, then deduct 28. So how much it will be?
Degree 180 minus 118 minus 28 34 degree 34.
So the y will be 34 degree. Okay, here we can find the similar way. Since this is x0, that means this is corresponding to this, this is 28 degree, right?
Yes,
because this angle must be same. So if we take the P, angle P, it will be what? 180 degree minus 1118 minus 28 degree. Okay. So what will be the value? The same. That means this was 34. This will also be 34 degree. Got this point?
Yeah.
Similarly, you can write this C. They have given what? The vertex, right? The side value they have given. So you can find the factor and multiply with the similar side, right?
34 is scale factor or original area?
It's called scale factor. Because this is the...
Oh, then 34... Then 34 times 180.
No. I'm talking about the C.
Oh, number C. Oh.
B is okay. B is done. So for this kind of things, what we have learned?
For C.
What we have learned?
I have to find the...
We have to take the ratio of side. Okay, so this is reverse, yes. Right? It will be
yes
inverse of this. Okay, so okay. Let's take a ratio. What we are having? We are having this 6 and 10, right?
Yes.
And here, this side and this side. This side one is x. This side y, and this side 18. Okay, these two sides we can.
Wait, 18 is y with y, and 12 is x.
No, see, our formula was x equals to scale factor plus into corresponding side, right?
Yes.
So see here. Scale factor we cannot find. See, this is just opposite. We need to rotate it, right, to make it similar. So yes. This and this same side. Okay.
Okay.
This and this same side. This and this same side. So we have only this value is there. This value is there, right, for the same side. So we can write AB by PQ. That means AB is what? 10. And PQ is what? 6. So it will be 5 by 3 scale factor. So if we want to find this one, the value of X is what? Is similar to
is
one, right?
Yes, then 5 by 3 times 12.
So X equals to 5 by 3 into 12.
Times 12.
12 4, that means 20.
20 centimeter.
Okay.
Okay. And the same thing with y, just 5 by 3 times 18.
Y equals 5 by 3 times
18.
18.
This is 30.
6. This is 30. Okay.
Okay.
This is the scale factor. You can do similar way the all other things, right?
Yes.
Okay. Now let's see the last one. Here, which pair of the shape are congruent? It's easy.
Yes.
Which are congruent?
I and K.
I and K. Then?
Then E and C.
E and C. E and C. Then?
D and G.
D and?
G, G, G.
Okay. Then?
And then J, B and J.
B and J. Then?
And nothing else.
Why not this one? A and F.
Oh, yes.
So these two are not congruent, okay?
Okay.
Number two, the two picture given. Given that PQRST similar to VWXYZ, copy and complete each of the following. PQ equals to VW. PQ equals to VW. Okay?
VW, that means then
3.5 equals to how centimeter?
3.5 is equals to
3.5. Similar.
Oh yes, 3.5.
PT dash 2 centimeter. PT which one?
PT.
PT equals to what?
PT YZ. YZ.
Y? No.
And Z.
PT. YZ how? VZ. VZ.
V oh VZ.
Yeah.
I thought that looked like Y.
Hmm. So you can write the remaining one, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Wait, what's the last one?
This one?
Yes.
See?
P oh, wait. R. VWX is equals to 90 degree.
90 degree.
Okay.
So you can calculate these all these things by yourself with the formula that we have seen.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Okay. Do it yourself. Okay?
Okay.
So, bye.